With more and more Americans aware of their cholesterol levels today, you see Questran Light in a lot of places. That's because Questran Light is first-step drug therapy for treating elevated cholesterol, no matter what their number. Questran Light with NutraSweet is an improved formulation. Less powder, good tasting, and it's easy to take. Non-systemic Questran Light fits right in with a healthy lifestyle. It's easy to take along, too. And all it takes is one dose in the morning and one in the evening to get started on reducing the risk of coronary heart disease. And isn't that what lowering cholesterol is all about? So write light. Questran Light. Cholestyramine for oral suspension.
When we come back, major medical news of the week and the state of the art in medical imaging.
Imagine what our educational programs would be like without our sponsors. The next time you see a representative from a company that advertises on your favorite program, say thank you for supporting Lifetime Medical Television.
TNF and IL-1 are important cytokines which mediate inflammation in the brain and meninges. Just how does this impact on therapy?
TNF and IL-1 are the seminal mediators, and if we can inhibit their production, we feel that inflammation can be greatly reduced.
Please join Dr. Steven Zinner, our special guests, and me for Infectious Disease 91.
Next Sunday at 4 p.m. on Lifetime Medical Television.
Because your patients with angina or hypertension are subject to each day's ups and downs, they need a drug that isn't. Procardia XL nifedipine extended release tablets. Constant control of angina and hypertension that lasts all day and night and into the next morning with one daily dose. The most common side effects are headache and edema.
Nicoderm, nicotine transdermal system, available soon from Marion Merrill Dow.
Cultivating an effective approach to the treatment of hypertension requires attention to the broad range of therapeutic options. Now there's a calcium channel blocker from Merck Sharp and Dohme for the treatment of mild to moderate hypertension. New Plendil, olodipine. Plendil focuses more activity on vascular smooth muscle than cardiac muscle. Plendil lowers blood pressure mainly by decreasing peripheral vascular resistance. Plus, it provides the convenience of once-a-day dosing. New, once-a-day, vascular selective Plendil. Plendil may occasionally precipitate significant hypotension and rarely syncope. It may lead to reflex tachycardia, which in susceptible individuals may precipitate angina pectoris.
Doctors, for prescribing information of advertised products, consult your PDR, tune into Lifetime Medical Television Sunday 11:30 p.m. to 1 a.m. or call 1-800-762-2395.
Family Practice Update is produced in cooperation with the American Academy of Family Physicians.
Hello, I'm Dr. Bob Rakel. Welcome to Family Practice Update.
It's the latest medical advances brought to life. Through sight and sound, doctors get direct exposure to important medical procedures. Ultrasound. Fetal surgery. Diagnostic gastroscopy. Fine needle biopsy. And many others. It's all day, every Sunday, so doctors can choose viewing times at their convenience. It's information directed to a doctor's special needs and interests. Cardiology. Internal medicine. Obstetrics and gynecology. Family practice. It's the network devoted entirely to physicians. An engaging look at medicine in action. Lifetime Medical Television. We bring medical information to life.
Lifetime Medical Television takes this opportunity to thank the American Academy of Family Physicians, the American Academy of Pediatrics, the American College of Cardiology, the American College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists, the American College of Physicians, and the American Dental Association. We appreciate the cooperation of such great medical organizations. They represent a valuable commitment to an important medical educational resource. Lifetime Medical Television. Experts discuss using a newly developed assay for diagnosing hepatitis C. Watch Internal Medicine Update. Next, here on Lifetime Medical Television.
Lately, patients have been asking me a lot of questions about over-the-counter analgesics. What to use for what? Side effects? What works? Now, I've always preferred Tylenol for pain relief when patients have certain conditions. Like Michelle there for her laceration. There was a bleeding risk, so I recommended Tylenol.
Put him in three.
Arlen Barrett for his headaches. He takes an anticoagulant, Tylenol again. Then there's Paula Ritter. Now, that's a little different. She's perfectly healthy otherwise, just strained her back, so I used to suggest aspirin or ibuprofen. I guess I thought they were more effective, but it's not true. In fact, the data show that for mild to moderate pain, 1,000 milligrams of Tylenol is actually more effective than 650 milligrams of aspirin, and as effective as 400 milligrams of ibuprofen. So I'm getting effective pain relief, along with the excellent safety profile I've always associated with Tylenol. Paul Ritter's back strain? I'll tell her to take extra strength Tylenol. It'll make us both feel good.
How does this Nobel Prize-winning cardiologist treat angina? Tune in Sunday, November 10th at 5:30 p.m. when Dr. Bernard Laun describes the benign nature of coronary disease.
Give us 30 minutes each week, and we'll keep you current with the most important articles in the world's leading medical journals. Watch Journal Watch. Today on Lifetime Medical Television at 5 and 7 p.m. Eastern and Pacific Times. Presented by the Massachusetts Medical Society and produced by American Medical Video.
An update on Lifetime Medical Television. We bring medical information to life.